Hello everyone, welcome to my channel for ServiceNow Learning TechnoMonk. Have you ever felt the thrill of configuring a ServiceNow flow only to crash into frustration when your trigger doesn't fire exactly when it should? You're not alone. Triggers are the nerve center of any flow, deciding when your automation springs into action. Today we are diving into the new and improved world of flow triggers in ServiceNow Yokohama release. By the end of this video, you will have the arsenal to tackle triggers with precision, paving the way for smoother, more reliable automation. Imagine you are building a mission-critical solution for your organization. Everything depends on flow firing at the perfect moment. But then you discover your triggers are either too broad, catching every type of record change, or too narrow, missing important events. That's like organizing a party, but only some guests see the invitation in ServiceNow Yokohama invitation. In ServiceNow Yokohama release, we get next level control over triggers, ensuring that not only they will fire on the right time, but they will do so under the exact condition you define. No more guesswork, no more messy configuration, just beautifully timed automation. So let's understand it with an example. Let's meet Ria, a ServiceNow developer who once found herself tangled in a web of condition-based triggers. She had separate flows for new incidents, multiple of them, okay? Updated problem records and time-based check. Each trigger had complicated filters, making it tough to maintain. Then Yokohama came along with the advanced trigger option that changed her life forever. So let's jump onto the demo. In order to get the trigger, what you have to do, you have to just go and type trigger. And under process automation, you will be finding a model called triggers. As soon as you click on this particular model, it will route you to the workflow studio. Over here, you can see now we have one more option to create triggers. Or if you go for new, there will be one option over here to create a trigger. Okay. From here, you can create a trigger. So what exactly trigger means? So whenever we used to create a flow before, right? The first and the foremost thing whenever we create a flow is to create a trigger. What should be the trigger condition to trigger that particular flow? And there's a possibility that a lot of flows are getting triggered on one condition itself, right? If we make a common entity out of it, or if we make a generic solution, so that we can create one trigger and then we can reuse that particular trigger whenever required over the flow. Okay. For example, if there are four flows which get triggers when the incident priority is one, then why to create condition four times? Why to create a trigger action four times, right? Instead of that, we can create a centralized trigger action and then we can use it out in all the different flows, all the four flows. What is the advantage of it? For instance, if we want to update the condition in the future, right? You don't have to go and find every flow and update the condition in each of them. You can simply update it at the centralized place and the things will be done for you. So when we click on new trigger, this will be the interface you will be getting. Okay. So for example, I will give the name. Today we'll be dealing with the change request. I want to create a trigger for the change for the normal change request when the priority is quite high. Okay, so I will give change request priority. Okay, I will give any name. Trigger type, when the record got created. Okay, I will give that. And I will give description. Description, I always try to give description so that it will be easy for the developers also to understand what exactly is the mindset for this trigger. This is the trigger for normal change. I will give this only. It's in the global scope. If you want to go for additional property, accessible from which scope, category, if you want to categorize it out and all those things out, you can do that also. But I will just go ahead and create a build trigger. And now the trigger is getting created. It will take some time. Honestly speaking, this is one of the best feature I feel I had in the Yokohama release. I'll be using it out extensively, quite extensively. I will be showing why. Okay, also, let's get it load first. Till then, if you have any feature which you liked from the Yokohama release, please drop a comment around the same. Okay, probably I will also try to explore around the same. And now it's created. The type is created. Now you can select the table. I will select the table as we are creating on the change request. So I will select change underscore request. Oh, my bad. Change request. And in conditions, we can define the conditions also. So conditions are getting loaded. So I will give what? I will give type of changes normal, and I want that what priority is triggered, then only this particular change should get proceeded. Now there is very interesting feature. I like this particular feature a lot. Okay, which is there is a toggle over here, allow user to view the condition. And there's a allow user to add additional condition. Why it's important, right? So I'm acting like an architect in my project, right? And whenever I ask my developers to create any flows, okay, based on certain trigger condition, as I mentioned in the context itself for the video, they will mess up with the condition, okay? So in this case, I can create the trigger for them and I can ask them to reuse that particular trigger only. They don't have to go deep into that, okay? And I can also hide it out from them. So if I disable this out, it will not be visible for them only. So they don't have to see. It's completely kind of encapsulation. They don't have to understand what exactly is happening into this particular trigger condition. They can simply use it out. And I'll be governing it out. If you enable it out, they'll be able to see it. And if you want, if you trust your developers, okay, then you can enable this particular option also, which will allow them to add additional condition on top of it. Also, one thing, as we have seen, it's getting auto-saved. Okay, so auto-save feature is enabled on this particular form also, so which is pretty nice. We have undo and redo button, perfect. And now we can, from here we can see post save we can do. We can see, look at the properties also. If I go over here, you can see these are properties which we have created. You can update that also. And you can publish it out. I'll be publishing this particular trigger. Okay, perfect. Now, the trigger got published. Now, how we can use this particular trigger into a flow. So, if I go to the flow, if I create a new flow, it's the same step. And the first and foremost step, whenever we try to create a flow, is create a trigger. Okay. And one disclosure I want to make, this is not a replacement for the legacy method, okay, for the trigger. You can do via legacy mean also, but this is an additional option if you want to use. Okay, so people started thinking now we have to create a trigger only and then we can create a flow. No, that's not the case. You can go with the legacy method also at this particular point of time also. It will take some time to load. Come on. Okay. And I will give a name as normal change flow. Okay. This build flow. And now we can see the trigger. So as I mentioned, still you can do the same. Or if I go with the created. Okay, and you can define change request and define the condition the way you used to do. But now we have an option. If I go over here global, I can see the trigger over here. And if I click on this particular trigger, voila, I don't have to do anything. I don't have to define any trigger condition. It's completely over here. Okay, and you can see as we have checked this particular property out, okay, that they will be able to see the condition. You can see this condition at the top also. Perfect. Now you can save this out and you can add action whatever you want, okay, on top of your flow. For example, ask for approval and so on and so forth. Now, one thing which might be buzzing in your mind, for example, on a trigger, I have around, for a specific trigger, I have around 5 flows created, okay? And suddenly, if I go and change the trigger, will it impact all the flows? So let's try to do that thing. So what I'll do, I will first save this out, okay? And I'll go to this particular change request. I will go to edit trigger. Now I want to add one more thing, critical, or it should be high. And if I try to publish now, okay, I get this particular publish trigger. It's just a confirmation dialog box and it showcases me that, hey, this particular trigger is used in this particular flow. And if you do the changes, there's a possibility that it will impact this flow. So do you want to go ahead and do the changes, publish the trigger, or you want to just revisit this particular flow first? So what I'll be doing in my day-to-day scenario, I'll revisit this change. I'll see the trigger condition. Okay, this particular flow, I don't think if I change the condition on this particular trigger, it will be the right way to do the things. Okay, probably it will break certain things for me. So what I can do in that case, I can simply, you can see over here, detach name trigger, right? I can simply detach this particular flow from that trigger. If I do that, it will ask me for a dialog box. Yes, I'm sure. And I have detached from that flow. But I have retained the condition from that trigger. Isn't it amazing? Right? So I can simply save and I can go to the trigger, because I've seen for other flow, it's completely fine. Okay. So if I try to publish now, I don't see any flow because I've detached it from there, and I will publish it out. And now it's able to reuse at other flows also. So, and like, just like that, Olivia transformed her complicated tangled of flows into a streamlined system powered by smart, reliable triggers. Now it's your turn to take these tips and weave them into your own ServiceNow environment. By embracing advanced configuration, consolidated triggers, scheduling efficiency, and monitoring performance, you'll not only save time, you will save your sanity. If this video helped shed some light on the future of flow trigger, please like this video, subscribe, and drop comments below telling us which Yokohama feature you are excited to try. Your engagement helps this channel grow, allowing me to continue bringing you the latest and greatest in ServiceNow innovations. Thanks for watching and have a nice day ahead. Thank you.